Hi, welcome to Caterpillar's Tenaya Hills Proving Ground in Arizona. This is their demonstration area. I'm Larry Stewart with ForConstructionPros.com. I want you to meet Kelly Grimm, who's a marketing director with Caterpillar's General Construction Services Group. And I'm seeing Caterpillar recreate this interesting book about putting construction machines to bed. Good night, construction site. And the services group is really playing an important role in this. They're kind of nurturing these machines, tucking them in at night and that sort of thing. What's going on in services in the real world at the construction site level that Caterpillar's responding to these days?
As you know, we have a very intentional focus on services. We've talked about that with the industry over the last couple of years, and we'll continue to have that very strong presence and focus on services. And so, as you know, we've launched a customer value agreements probably about 2 years ago, and we're continuing to add different services to that. And, you know, it's great. Customers are taking that. They're getting that when they're buying those machines, but now it's time for that renewal. And so we're seeing it about 50% of customers are renewing those agreements.
Wow.
So definitely the customers are seeing the benefits, the convenience, the hassle-free. I mean, we talk about that at Caterpillar, but obviously customers are seeing that as well as they're agreeing to do that renewal with us.
And that's a pretty significant increase from service agreements that were happening before that, right?
It is. In the past, we saw about a 20% renewal. And so now with the 50% renewal, we really had to take a step back and go, I mean, this is fantastic. We're excited to see that, but why? Yeah. And it truly is. It's that hassle-free ownership. We're delivering parts where they need them, when they need them. Our dealers are working hand in hand with customers. The great thing with telematics anymore is we know where the machine is located. So if the customer would like to have the preventive maintenance kits delivered to the machine, we know where that machine is, we can deliver it there. It really is all about that service and making sure that it's easy for the customer to get those parts and to get that service that they need.
Well, what kinds of differences are there between these customer value agreements and this customer service agreements that we saw before?
True intentional focus on services and making sure that we are going beyond what we were offering in the past. I think now you've seen there's like different ones. We can do the basic with the PM kits, and to the point where we can make them customizable all the way to include the dealer service. So it really is making sure that we're flexible, we're meeting the needs of the customer. Every customer is different. And so we want to make sure that it's not a one size fit all. To make sure that we're meeting what they need.
Is that kind of an example of, you know, providing customers specifically what they want?
Yeah, absolutely. So our self-service options, that is something that launched in the marketplace about a year ago, and we're continuing to expand that. And what that is, it's the parts, it's the service instructions, it's technical hotline or technical assistance, as well as the recommended tooling. Now I say that, but it's not a kit. So it kind of sounds like a kit, but it really allows the customer to pick what they need.
Yeah.
And so, you know, as an example, maybe they don't need all the bolts that would come with it, and they can select not to get those. And they can get that through the parts counter at the dealership or on parts.cat.com. I think we're all so used to e-commerce anymore to go on there, and they can select what they would actually like included with that. Get the in-service instructions, they have that technical assistance, and again, the recommended tooling.
They just go into a menu online and say, you know, these are the parts I need, you know, yeah, send me the list of recommended tooling and the instructions, you know, I don't need these things, and that stuff's going to show up where they want it, right?
Right, absolutely. And we started this last year mainly focusing on some of our smaller equipment, such as skid steers or compact track loaders. Mm-hmm. We have expanded that into more of our mid-size equipment, so maybe looking at some of the dozers we have, the motor graders, as well as our wheel loaders and such. So looking to continue to expand that. We've seen some great success and some good uptake from customers with the self-service agreements. So we want to make sure that we're continuing to offer more to make that easy for customers. I mean, that's what it all comes down to.
Yeah.
Not everyone's going to come to the dealership for service. We would love them to. We welcome them to do that.
Sure.
But there are times when it's just easier for them to do the service themselves.
What other kinds of things is CAT's service organization using that data for in order to make that partnership with customers even more productive?
Technology is constantly evolving. We see that in our everyday lives that we all are experiencing. And so a couple of the technology areas that we're focusing on is remote troubleshoot and remote flash. So one of the great things with telematics is we know where the machine is. We can send the update via flash. doesn't require a technician to go out, doesn't mean they have to power it down and wait. It just makes sure that we send that directly to the machine. It can do its update and then it can move on. Same with remote troubleshoot. If the customer is having any challenges with their machine, we can remote into that machine, kind of figure out what's going on. We can have that consultation, the dealer's working with the customer to say, okay, this is what we're seeing. This is how we would diagnose this. And then they can work through what does that plan look like. Dealer can do the service, customer can, we can know what parts they need. So again, making sure that there's less downtime and also making it easier to diagnose what is the challenge that the machine's having at that time.
Given the fact that, you know, Caterpillar's got these investments in really understanding what customers want and you know, gone to the effort to try and offer them all the choices that they want and need to get the value that they really want. So I really appreciate your time and wish you the best of luck, Kelly.
Absolutely, Larry. Thanks so much. I appreciate you taking the time to chat with me.